Hello dear friends, welcome to EPG Paathshala. I am Shankar Narayan Paliri, Assistant Professor, NSS Training College, Ottappalam, Kerala. Today, I would like to present before you a learning module of Education Committees and Commissions pursued in India after freedom. Let me present the objectives of the module first. To acquaint the learners with the development of education in India after freedom. To evaluate the contributions of education commissions and committees appointed by Government of India time to time. To critically analyze the contributions of education endeavors in India after freedom. Dear friends, now we are going to briefly describe the educational development before 1947, I mean before independence. That will help us to know the context before freedom. The platform for national-level educational reforms in independent India is constructed by British rule itself. The colonial period framed basic structure for most of the independent reforms. The British period reforms started from the Charter Act 1813 and Macaulay's Minutes, and it ended with the Sargent Report in 1944. The independent India made educational developments based upon the enormous structures made by the British rule. Free India was in need of vast expansion of education scenario. It was expected the reconstruction of Indian educational system from toes to top. Several committees and commissions were appointed after 1947, aiming the reframing and strengthening of education sector. Now we can discuss them one by one. The first of them is University Education Commission, 1948-49. After independence, a commission was appointed under the chairmanship of Dr. S. Radhakrishnan. It was the first commission for higher education sector that Free India had constituted. Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan was a distinguished scholar and former vice chancellor of Banaras Hindu University and who became the second president of India. The commission was appointed to assert the problems and prospects of Indian higher education, particularly university education. The commission was appointed in November 1948 and it submitted its report in August 1949. Since Dr. Radhakrishnan was the chairman of the commission, it is known as Radhakrishnan Commission. The commission constituted with 10 members. The Government of India appointed the commission with a due realization that a reconstruction of university education was essential for national cultural resurgence. The commission measured and suggested provisions on teaching standard, the teaching standard of the universities, teachers' qualifications, research, professional education, women education, curriculum and examination. Some of the suggestions were introduction of new service conditions and payment for higher education teachers, introduction of academic performance awarding for teachers, enrichment of libraries, laboratories and other supporting infrastructures, refresher courses for teachers, provisions for better use of language, introduction of facilities for research and related studies, changes in examination pattern and evaluation, and three language formula for graduate level students. The University Education Commission has emphasized that the teachers play a vital role in the education system. Therefore, an adequate faculty with required qualifications are necessary to discharge many types of duties in a university or in a college. Care should be taken in the selection procedure of a teacher for the appointment as a professor, reader, and lecturer. Agriculture education should be recognized as an important national issue. Regarding medical education, the Commission recommended that the maximum number of admissions should be 100 in a medical college. The standard of success at the various examinations should be uniform in all universities. Viva Voce examination should be employed only for professional courses and postgraduate degrees. The students should undergo thorough physical examination at the time of admission and at least once in a year thereafter. All universities must have hospital and health service. Radhakrishnan Commission also suggested that all students in a college or university should receive either NSS or NCC training. Students' union should be free from political motives and activities. Another major suggestion was that university grant commission should be set up for allocating grants to the universities. Radhakrishnan Commission designed a structural hierarchy for universities. The structure came like this: the chancellor, vice chancellor, the senate or court, the syndicate or the executive council, the academic council, the faculties, the board of studies, the finance committee and the selection committee. It suggested compulsorily 12 years school education before joining the college. The commission identified secondary education as the weakest link in the whole structure of Indian education. Friends, I hope you got a gist of the University Commission 1948. Now, we can discuss another commission that is appointed by Government of India, the Secondary Education Commission or Lakshman Swami Mudaliar Commission in 1952. Let us discuss the background of appointing the Secondary Education Commission. The Central Advisory Board of Education, at its 14th meeting held in January 1948, recommended the appointment of a commission to examine the prevailing system of secondary education in the country. Taking this request into consideration, a commission was appointed by Government of India with the aim of reorganizing the secondary education system of the country. The comment of Radhakrishnan Commission that our secondary education remains the weakest link in our educational machinery and needs urgent reform was another leading reason to constitute the committee. It was appointed in September 1952 under the chairmanship of Lakshman Swami Mudaliar, the then Vice Chancellor of Madras University. The commission was inaugurated on 6th October 1952. It submitted its report on June 1953. The terms of references before the committee were: examine the existing system of secondary education in the country, suggest measures for its reorganization and improvement, suggest measures for educational and vocational guidance at secondary level, suggest steps for vocational education. The commission located on certain facts as aims of secondary education in India. They are: development of democratic citizenship, improvement of vocational efficiency of youths, education for leadership quality, development of personality. The coming are some of the major recommendations of the Secondary Education Commission. Education, along with imparting knowledge in an efficient manner, should focus at inculcating desirable values, proper attitudes, and habits of work in the students. Emphasis in teaching should shift from verbalism and memorization to learning through realistic situation and experiences. Should promote group life and cooperative work in education. The Mudaliar Commission recommended new pattern of education as: the duration of secondary education should be for 7 years. It should cover the age of group of 11 to 17. Secondary education should commence after 4 or 5 years of primary or junior basic education. The middle or senior basic or lower secondary stage should cover a period of 3 years, and the higher secondary stage should also cover 3 years. Technical schools should be started in large number. The other major recommendations were: integrated elementary education, 3 years secondary education with a marked diversification of subjects, 3 years university education to get the first degree, establishment of multipurpose schools and conversion of selected schools to multipurpose schools, reform of secondary level examination system to objective based, continuous and comprehensive evaluation, and also recommended 3-language formula, appointment of qualified teachers, improvement in teaching methods. The Secondary Education Commission has recommended some principles to be followed in the construction of curriculum. They are principles of variety and elasticity, principle of training for leisure, and principle of integration and correlation of curriculum. Dear students, we can see that the Mudaliar Commission constituted its report highly comprehensive. The report evaluated all aspects of secondary education and marked its difficulties and shortcomings. It was a remarkable step in the educational history of India. Now we are going to discuss about another important education attempt, and that is Kothari Commission or Indian Education Commission 1964. The Indian Education Commission, that is popularly known as Kothari Commission, was appointed by Government of India on July 1964. The commission included 7 Indian members and 5 foreigners. The foreigners, one each from Japan, UK, USSR or Russia, France and USA. The commission also had 20 consultants from different countries and also from UNESCO. The report entitled Education and National Development that had submitted in June 1966 before the Central Minister of Education. The preamble statement of the report that the future of India is being shaped in her classrooms is very famous. India outlined its first national policy on education in 1968 based on the Kothari Commission report. Major recommendations of the Kothari Commission. Science education should become an integral part of school education. Education should focus on modernization. The commission stated that the modernization is a healthy symbol of change. Education is the key to open the door of modernization. Work experience should be introduced as a factor leading to technology and industrialization. Secondary education should be vocationalized. Common school system and encouragement of neighborhood schools were suggested by the commission. Some other remarks are special attention to the education of women, handicapped, backward classes, tribes, and scheduled classes. Free textbooks and study materials to primary stage students. Some form of social and national service should be made obligatory to all students. Implementation of moral and spiritual education at all levels. Imparting of guidance and counseling for school students. The commission proposed to give liberal assistance to improve the salary of school teachers. The commission also recommended 60 years as the age of retirement for teachers. Introduction of 10 plus 2 plus 3 pattern all over the country is suggested by Kothari Commission. The Kothari Commission suggested WE, which is popularly known as work experience, compulsory to schools. A pattern has suggested for its implementation. The pattern should come like this. For lower primary sessions, simple handworks. For upper primary, craft works. For lower secondary, workshop training, gardening, etc. For higher secondary, workshop training, farmhouse training, commercial industrial training, and so on. Another major suggestion was the 3-language formula. It introduced with the aim of social development and national integration. Mother tongue suggested as compulsory subject at a school level. 3-language formula is compounded with mother tongue, Hindi, English or any other foreign languages. It comes like this. Mother tongue as first language, Hindi as national language and English as foreign language. This is applicable to non-Hindi speaking areas. And one more point we have to remember. The foreign language can be French, Spanish or any other language instead of English. For Hindi speaking areas, Hindi is the language as mother tongue, any one of modern national language as second language and English as foreign language. For example, the 3-language formula in the schools of Karnataka state will work like this. Mother tongue, Kannada as the first language, English as the foreign language and Hindi as national language. Then a student from Karnataka has to learn Kannada, English and Hindi. Dear students, Kothari Commission was a major step in the history of Indian education. It is highly comprehensive in its attempts. The commission marked with very fruitful contributions. Now we can discuss about the Isharbhai Patil Committee 1968. This was a review committee established under the chairmanship of Dr. Isharbhai Patil, who was a former vice chancellor of Gujarat University. Major aim of the committee was overall review of NPE 1968. The committee suggested the formal and non-formal education, strengthening of instructional methods, flexibility of curriculum, work education, etc. It preferred and suggested the term socially useful productive works for work experiences. Another review committee appointed by Government of India was known as Plus Two National Review Committee. This was formed in October 1977 under the chairmanship of Dr. Adisheshayya. Commission recommended occasionalization of plus two course all over India. It also suggested work-based learning, semester system, credit system, and changes of teaching methods. Now come to National Education Policy 1986. After Kothari Commission, our governments have taken a long interval to introduce major educational reforms. Governments began to think of a new policy in education in 1984, and Rajiv Gandhi government had implemented National Policy of Education in 1986. The NPE in 1986 reviewed the condition of Indian education from 1968 and formulated a new policy of education. The policy proposed a program of action for strengthening of Indian education. The program of action suggested the following objectives and the introduction of common educational structure all over India, that is 10 plus 2 plus 3 pattern. Ensure equality of educational opportunity to all. National wide curriculum framework. Introduction of a project named Operation Blackboard, with an aim of immediate development in infrastructural facilities in schools. Introduction of minimum level learning or MLL scheme at each stage of education. Special attention to primary education for all. NPE 1986 suggested universal enrollment of children up to the 14 years and development of quality of education. Strengthening of open schooling, open universities, and distance learning system were also the suggestions. Opening of Navodaya Vidyalayas, introduction of computer education at schools, review of national education system once in every 5 years. By that, government can assess the reforms made and the progress achieved, and can also provide guideline for developments in future. Curriculum should project India's composite culture, heritage, and resources. It should promote national and social integration and values, and also create scientific advancement and technological development. Strengthening of NCERT, SCERT, DIETS, NCTE, Academy Staff Colleges, and other agencies were also suggested by 1986 NPE. We see that NPE suggested for review of educational developments in the country in every 5 years. To keep this suggestion in practice, the first review committee was appointed in 1990. That was Acharya Ramamurthy Review Committee. This committee was appointed in May 1990 with the aim of overall review of NPE 1986. Acharya Ramamurthy was a social activist, Gandhian, educationist, and academic. The report submitted by the committee to Government of India was entitled Towards an Enlightened Human Society. The committee suggested following. Common school system, which is neglected by NPE 1986, should be revamped. Measures should be taken for the removal of disparities in education and to stop wastage and stagnation. Reforms in evaluation should be introduced according to the social, psychological, and technological developments. Establish autonomous educational institutions. Stress to value education. Extension of project Operation Blackboard to higher standards. Acharya Ramamurthy committee had certain specific views regarding women education. It suggested that the responsibility for planning, implementing, and monitoring of all school-based programs for women's education should be handed over to the Panchayat Raj framework. At the institutional level, the head of the institution, either of primary school, middle school, or higher secondary schools, should be made fully responsible for planning and ensuring universalization of girls' education. The committee also recommended that all school textbooks, both by NCERTs or SCERTs and other publishers, to be reviewed to eliminate the invisibility of women and any type of gender discriminations. Another review committee was appointed under the chairmanship of Janardhan Reddy, who was Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh. The committee was appointed in May 1991 and it submitted its report in January 1992. The committee suggested changes in policy and action plan for policy implications. On the basis of the reports of Acharya Ramamurthy Committee and Janardhan Reddy Committee, the Government of India introduced some amendments in National Policy of Education 1986. It has made the following amendments in the national policy. A minimum of 3 big classrooms and 3 teachers will be arranged in every primary schools. In future, 50% of the teachers appointed in the primary schools will be females. The Operation Blackboard plan will be implemented in senior schools also. A national mission will be launched to achieve the goal of free and compulsory education by the year 2000. Emphasis will be placed on the enrollment of girls, SC and ST children and in the secondary education. A national evaluation organization will be formed for the reform in examination and evaluation. Now friends, we are going to discuss another major venture in the recent history of education commissions and committees, that is Eshpal Committee 1992. Eshpal is an Indian scientist and educationist. He is known for his contributions in science as well as for being an institution builder. In his later years, he has become one of the leading science communicators of the country. Let us see what was the background of appointment of Eshpal Committee. There had strong opinions among the educational experts and policymakers that education must focus on quality. Though the country have enough educational institutions at all levels of schools, the quality of the outputs are not at all satisfactory. And in many cases, our students experience overburden in the academic activities. The level of learning of students remained very low. Taking all such problems, the Ministry of Human Resource appointed a committee in March 1992 with the title of National Advisory Committee under the chairmanship of Professor Eshpal. Committee submitted its report in July 1993 entitled Learning Without Burden. Major recommendations of the committee were: learning should be joyful. For that, commission suggested emphasis on group activities and cooperative learning. Minimize competitions where individual achievements are highly considered and rewarded. High consideration and rewards should go to group achievements. Freedom to teachers on textbook and other learning materials. Decentralization of textbook preparation and transaction. Textbook preparation should be a coordinative venture of school teachers, experts and consultants. Formation of committees at school, village and district levels to undertake planning and supervision of school activities. Cluster groups are to be formed on all subjects with a coordination of different schools. Financial aids to school, which is at the disposal of school head for purchase, repair and replace pedagogical equipments to facilitate student learning. Abolish tests and interviews for admission to nursery and primary classes. Separate time schedule to use textbook and notebooks to lessen the heavy load of carry bags. Reduce teacher-pupil ratio to 1:30 at primary levels. Promote use of electronic media in education. And another important suggestion is that the B.Ed. course should be a regular full-time course and must able to mould teacher behavior, not at all content-oriented. Save children from rote memorization. Concept-based questions are to be promoted. Voluntary organizations with a specific commitment to pedagogical innovations shall be provided greater freedom and support in developing curriculum, textbooks and teacher training. The culture of writing textbooks can be changed so as to involve much large number of teachers in the preparation of textbooks. The scientists and experts in various disciplines may be associated with the preparation of textbooks as consultants and not as writers of the books. The B.Ed. program should offer the possibility of specialization in secondary or elementary or nursery education. The emphasis in these programs should be on enabling the trainees to acquire the ability for self-learning and independent thinking. Pre-service teacher education program, being a professional course, has to be rigorous, thorough and intensive program. Therefore, the commission suggested B.Ed. degree courses by correspondence should be derecognized. The continuing education of teachers must be institutionalized. The organization of in-service education programs and other activities aimed at the professional growth of teachers be designed and conducted effectively. Friends, our discussion in this module are about major commissions and committees appointed by Government of India time to time in the scenario of education. Various commissions and committees were appointed at different times to survey, study, review, and recommend improvements in the existing system, policies and programs of education. Now, let us see the names of all commissions and committees that constituted by Government of India regarding general and public education. All of them are presented in this table. Now, let me take your attention to the gist of the module. We discussed the committees and commissions on education appointed after independence. Radhakrishnan Commission on University Education, Mudaliar Commission, Kothari Commission, Isharbhai Patel Committee, NPE 1986, Ajarya Ramamurthy Committee, Janardhan Reddy Committee, Eshpal Committee are the major ones we discussed. I hope that this will help you to have a picture on our nation's commitment for educational development. Thank you.